We are in the biggest city of Somerset, a UNESCO World Heritage Site. We are going to explore Bath, and if you stay tuned till the end, there is a bonus place that I will show you as well. You can visit from Bath.
Bath became really a city in 60 AD, when the Romans built baths and a temple in the valley of the River Avon. At that time, the place was known as Aqua Sulis, translated as the Waters of Sul. This Roman influence is something you will clearly see back in the city. Now, first stop in Bath is on Pulteney Bridge, designed by Robert Adam and completed in 1773. A Grade 1 listed place in the UK. And this is only one out of four bridges in the world that has shops consisting on both sides of the bridge, completing the whole span of the bridge. And one of those shops are antique map shop, a flower shop, some juice shops. And let's continue to the next stop. And then the main attractions of Bath are, of course, Bath Abbey and the Roman baths. And Bath Abbey was constructed in the 7th century and rebuilt and extended in the 12th and 16th century. And then in the 19th century, they restored it to this original piece in the Gothic style. Inside, they are still doing reconstruction work because they are taking all the stones out. They're putting the pipes in, and then they're filled with hot water coming from the Roman baths to give a natural source of heating to the abbey. And then the first king of England, King Edward, is crowned here as well. So it's a place with a lot of history and a lot of passionate people inside, where you can visit the abbey for free and they are more than happy to tell you everything about religion. I'm not really into that, so I'm going to tell more about the history of the Roman baths that you can find right opposite the building.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven.
Before we continue our walk around Bath, I have to show you the place where we are staying, Grosvenor Villa. A house that only stands here because in 1830 Bath Abbey removed the ornate Italian-style altar piece for a more Gothic version. This altar piece is from 1725, and Thomas Shew, an artist and collector, bought this altar piece and built this house onto his other house to provide a home to this altar piece. The current owners really keep this old style alive, from the entrance hall to the living room. Even the bedroom, and please don't pay attention to our mess, everything looks amazing. There are some weird collectibles that you can find, and the dining room where you have breakfast looks stunning. It even has a piano from the 1930s, where you're able to play on.
And then the Roman baths are probably the most famous attractions here in Bath, which you can visit by paying £12.50 for adults, but I've already been in there, so I'm not going to do that now. But they are definitely worth a visit, because the baths are still functioning. You can't take a bath yourself, but they still function, the water is still working. They give you a very nice description about how it would have looked like in the past, because you might have seen all those marble art pieces and think that's how it looked like in the past. No, Romans painted everything, so also the temples and the baths, they all were colored at that time. But if you want to take a bath in Bath, there are still some places around that use the same water that's laying here underneath as their source to still have a little bit of that Roman experience.
After the baths, we passed Sally Lunn's historic eating house, apparently the oldest known building in Bath in 1496. Not sure how that works with Bath Abbey and the Roman baths that are definitely older than that. We also passed Theatre Royal, opened in 1805, one of the largest provincial theatres in the UK, built in 1720 and showing a great Georgian architecture. But now it is time to move on to some of the highlights of Bath.
I have just arrived at the circus, which was formerly known as the Royal Circus, which is maybe more impressive than
the Royal Crescent, which we are visiting after this place. But this place consists of three building blocks, and this forms a perfect round circle based on Georgian architecture. It's pretty impressive to have such a perfect round place here in Bath. And we are in Royal Crescent, the most famous crescent of them all, built in 1774, designed by John Wood the Younger. And it got its name because in the 18th century, Prince Frederick decided to move in one Royal Crescent. But there are more crescents out there in Bath. But the reason why this one is so famous is because of its scale. It's so big and it looks so impressive when you're standing here. And as a bonus, some tips of places to visit outside of Bath. Of course, you can visit Bristol, which provide great shopping opportunities, but also some great architecture. If, however, you look for something more remotely countryside, Bradford-on-Avon is a great choice that you can reach from Bath by bus or by car. Our visit only lasted 2 hours due to the gloomy weather, but it is a great place to have a look around. The history of this place can also be tracked back to the Romans. Several buildings are from the 17th century, when the town was thriving on the wool and textile industry. And with that, I hope you enjoyed your visit to Bath. And there are pigeons incoming. Wait a second.
It was wet.
Go, 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 go.